Let's chop up the domain into elements and nodes, which is called meshing. And in this step, we are not affecting the mathematical model, that is our boundary value problem. We are affecting how that is going to be solved. I'll come to the project page, right-click on model, and select edit. And that says starting mechanical. Okay, after mechanical comes up, you should see the tree over here, and mechanical is the primary interface to interact with the finite element solver. I'll highlight mesh and let me throw the default mesh at it. I'll say update. And I can see that, near the hole where I expect stress concentration, I need more resolution. And there are a couple of knobs I can twiddle, so I'll go under sizing, and you can see that the size function is selected to curvature, which means that it'll refine for curvature. If I expand this over here, this setting, curvature normal angle is 30 degrees, which means that each of these is 30 degrees. That's why I'm getting only three elements along the hole. So let me change that curvature normal angle to 10. Okay, and then I will say update. So now each of these, if I zoom in using the right mouse button, each of these is now spanning 10 degrees, which means I should get 9 divisions along that arc. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay, let me be greedy and change that to something lower, 2 degrees. So I should get about 45 elements along there, and I'll say update. Okay, so now I'm refining the hole much better through this curvature normal angle. And then if I zoom out using the middle mouse wheel, and I can translate by holding down control and moving with the middle mouse button, I see that it's transitioning to larger elements a little too quickly. And so I can control that using the growth rate. And the closer the growth rate is to 1, the slower it is going to transition. So let me try 1.2. And I will say update. Okay, it's still transitioning pretty quickly. How about if I, so let me make it closer to 1, say 1.1, and say update. Okay, now you can see that the transition is more gradual, and that's a good enough initial mesh. In the verification step, I need to check the effect of mesh refinement, but I think that's a mesh I will go with initially. And if I look overall, I mean, here I have large elements, but here the stress is going to be nearly uniform because we are far enough away from the hole, so that should be fine. And so in the process, I've marked out the points at which ANSYS should calculate the displacements directly. So if I zoom in here, I can select those points, the node. So if I zoom in using the right mouse button and then select node, and I'll come to this particular element. You can pick any element really. Hold down the control key and select the corners. Okay, so ANSYS is going to calculate U and V displacements at those four nodes, but you'll also see if I go to the midsides, there are the midside nodes. This means that it's using the second order interpolation by default. So if I have a point here and need to find the displacement at that point, it's going to be an interpolation involving all these, which is going to be a second order interpolation. It's going to be a weighted average of these many values. And since second order interpolation is better than first order interpolation, I will leave it at the default. And if I come here to statistics, I see that I have a total of 2936 nodes. And at each node, it'll calculate U and V, so into two, approximately 6,000 values is what I'm asking ANSYS to calculate directly by providing this mesh. I can save the project. I can save file, save the project. I can also go back to the workbench window and save file, archive, and overwrite the WBPZ. I'll say replace it, and I'll say archive. So now that WBPZ is also being updated, which means that to restore my project, I just need that file.